So Nate Spear here with Maximum Muscle Report, and I'm here with Seth Shaw, your overall bodybuilding winner from North American Championships from this last weekend. And we'll get started. Just give us a little bit of a recap of your bodybuilding history, how you got into it, what shows you've done.
Okay, so yeah, so I got started bodybuilding. I went to a bodybuilding show with my friend in 2009. We watched the Buckeye Classic here in Columbus, and we went to that, and he's like, you know what? I think you can do really well with this. So we watched that show, and then we went to work in the gym in 2010. In September, I did the Cardinal Classic, and I did the heavy novice class. I didn't do the open. I won my class there. I lost the overall. Then I went on to a Dave Lieberman show and placed like 10th out of 18th, and like Derek Natcher like stole the whole show. He got like caught off stage, and I was like, man, these guys, you know, these guys look legit, you know. So then I ended up doing like a little, it was a show in Newark. It was called like the ONBF, like the Ohio Natural Bodybuilding Federation or whatever. So I did that. I ended up winning the teen class and the novice, and then my friend Ben Hartman beat me in the overall, and he won like his natural pro card or whatever there. Yeah. And then I took a year off and did 2012, and I ended up winning my class two times the next year, and one in Dayton, one in Columbus. I did a Pittsburgh show. I got third there. And then after 2012, I decided to jump to the NPC, which I did the Ohio. I got like fourth in the heavyweights. And then the next year, I ended up doing the Ohio again, and I got third in the Supers, and I won an overall show in Michigan. Then I linked up with Phil Viz, and he took my off season, and we put on like, went from like 214 stage weight to 235. Nice. And we did the Junior USA. We got second in the Supers, and we won the Pittsburgh Super Heavies there and lost the overall to Dylan Williamson Jr. And then I linked up with Matt back in January of this year, and we went and did the North Americans, which I won my pro card.
Nice. So it's pretty crazy. Like, I've known you for a little bit now, and like, so I've seen pictures of when you first started. And honestly, if I saw you, like, I think you're like, I don't know, 180 something.
Yeah, I was like 180.
I would have told you, don't do bodybuilding. You should probably stop. And now it's like crazy to see how you transformed from like your first couple shows, and then now it's just like one of the craziest transformations I've seen. Like, have you ever in your mind said, I'll never be where you are today, like where you're sitting, like you just won North Americans, like when you started out, like were you ever like, oh, maybe I could be an IFBB pro?
Well, when I started out, you know, I was really into like the, you know, IMBF, and well, the gym that I was at, it was at Beyond Limits, and my first coach, Rich Laura, was always pushing me to do, try to be WBF pro, and then I got to thinking, I was like, you know what, well, you know, okay, so I went my pro car, the WNBF. There's like 9 shows a year. Yeah. Half of them are not even in the country. Huh. And like, so it's like, what's the point of me getting this natural pro card? Right. You know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah.
I was like, there's a lot more opportunity for me in the NPC to grow there. And then when I made the switch over to the NPC, my body just responded really well to everything. And I just kept growing and growing and growing. And I didn't really have a lot of knowledge with the people when I, some of the first coaches that I had. But I think like, as I kept moving up coaches and started getting more popular people in the industry, their knowledge base helped me get to where I'm at now. Like train with John, like really transformed my training a lot from where I did before. Like I do tons of high volume training, but now I kind of do more high intensity training, low volume, and I'm in and out of the gym. If I train by myself, it's like 30 minutes. If I train with him, it takes like an hour, hour and 15, because sometimes we talk around or whatever. Yeah. But it's usually in and out. We're pretty quick about everything. We don't take a lot of rest between our sets. It's just low volume, heavy sets. We're in and out.
Yeah, nice. So why don't you touch base a little bit on that? Like a lot of people might not know who John is. If you just want to give a quick summary and like what he's maybe taught you as far as training, maybe get in a little bit more of it. Like, just for example, like your leg training, we've talked about it. You've done like what? You haven't even squatted over 365 your whole prep, maybe?
Yeah. So with, you know, what we do with John, so John's like physical therapist. He does FR release, ART, you know, the whole nine. He's got tons of certifications and like the therapy side of like the body. So he knows how to like, you know, fix restricted areas, allow you to get full range of motion, activate all of your muscle tissue. So there's a lot of these guys, you know, they're not using full range of motion and they're not activating all the tissues that they need to stimulate to grow. So when I see these guys squatting 500 pounds and their legs aren't as big as mine, I'm squatting 315 ass to grass. There's, you know, there's a reason why my legs are growing, because I have full range of motion and I can activate all the muscle fibers that I need. So when we train, we don't train minimal, we don't train maximum, we train at optimal with weights. So for like legit with squats, we 315 to 335 was about all the weight we used for the entire year. For squats, and we did banded deadlifts and stuff like that leading up into the prep. And I think about I don't know, 12 weeks out, we kind of phased out the deadlifts, honestly, and just focused more on like the squats. And then we train in 3-week wave periods. So say you're doing legs. So we do regular squats for 3 weeks, and we take a deload week where maybe we do like leg press and more high rep stuff. And then the next 3-week phase, we would do like box squats. Okay. And then we continue to do that. So it's like 3 weeks on, 1 week off, 3 weeks on, 1 week off. And you're always rotating your exercises, because 3 weeks, your body reaches accommodation where you will plateau. So every 3 weeks, you need to rotate your exercises. Yeah.
So did you have the privilege of John working on your body, like maybe a lot during the prep, that make a huge difference?
Yeah, for sure. Because, a lot of the bigger guys, they can't rotate they don't have external rotation in their shoulders. So they can't, when they hit that back double bicep, mm-hmm. they can't rotate and crank on that shoulder. And so you can't see all the detail in their back because they're so restricted. So every week, John would go through both my hips, both my shoulders. And if my low back issues are kind of solved, kind of fixed that through the deadlift. Wow. But I had tons of low back issues where my psoas and stuff would get tight and have me hunched over, too. And also using the reverse hyper, it decompresses the spine when you bring your legs under and bring it back. So it kind of rehydrates the disc back there too. So we always use some sort of reverse hyper and within our training to keep healthy.
Yeah, sometimes it's all about having the right people surrounded by you. And a lot of people say it's an individual sport, you know what I mean, blah blah blah, but sometimes when you have the right pieces to the puzzle, it makes all the difference in the world, right?
100%. Yeah.
And then also, so the whole time you were prepping for the Mr. Olympia amateur, the first one, was the plan. It was sort of online, you know, you and Henry were going to have a rematch, and then sort of you snuck right in the North Americans, and I think a lot of people were just like, where'd this guy come from?
I actually just posted a vlog up on my YouTube channel about my whole prep of why, you know, just jumped in the North Americans, but we went to my buddy's house the night before. We went to that fight, the McGregor fight or whatever. Then I had to take Kate to the airport, and I took her to the airport, came back, slept for a few hours, ate, and went to the gym and did some cardio and abs and some reverse hyper. And something just kept telling me, you know, just do the North Americans, like just do the North Americans. So I messaged Matt when I was at the gym. I said, hey, man, what do you think about doing North Americans? He said, let's go for it. So let me make a call. So I called my buddy John Weiss. I was like, hey, man, it's like, you want to go do the North Americans with me, blah, blah, blah. So, you know, he decided he would take me up there. He's like, I've been telling you to do this show the whole year. He's like, I didn't tell you to do Olympia. I told you to do the North Americans since day one. I'm like, okay, man, well, let's just do it. So one of Kate's Instagram friends, she let me stay with her for 2 days in the hotel. So I got there on Tuesday night. John drove me up there. He had a client. She placed second in the Open. Oh, wow. And in a bikini. And I decided, you know, it was like a last second decision. I jumped in, I played my cards right, and I just, you know, came away with the win. So
nice. Do you think it like helped you at all, sort of fly under the radar, like less stress, maybe people not being like, you know, good luck, like da 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 da, like messaging you all the time, like because you sort of, no one really knew you were doing the show, right?
Yeah, because I mean, certain people would send me photos online. They were like, like, aren't you glad you're not doing North Americans? I'm like, dude, I don't really care. You know what I mean? Like, yeah. Plus, Instagram is you know, the pictures that you see online is not what you see in person. Yeah. It's these dudes. They look big in pictures. I look skinny in pictures because I'm so tall. You know, and then when you stand them next to me, I start bringing out their flaws. You know, they got blocky waist. I'm like super tall. They're super short. And I look like, you know, I'm towering over them.
Right.
And stuff like that. But I do feel like it was less pressure, you know, not saying, hey, I'm doing North Americans.
Yeah, yeah.
And then, you know what I mean? Right. So I did think it worked out in my benefit by just, you know, doing that.
I just think a lot of guys, like, tend to, I've been there myself. You just put a lot of pressure on yourself sometimes. Like, oh, like, you know what I mean? Like, posting pictures every week. And then, like, am I going to look up to, like, my pictures? You know what I mean? And sort of, like, you create more hype than you want. And then, like, cortisol can come into play like the final week, and you just start stressing out more. And sometimes I think what you did is like almost playing low key is like, you know, way less stress involved, you know.
Dude, that's exactly too. And I don't know if this contributes to anything, but my buddy Ben, I used his Morphicon product the entire prep, and because I usually stress like crazy, like my wife can attest to this, but like I used that supplement, and I swear by that, it like definitely made a difference and like relaxed me a little bit more. So I do think that kind of played a factor in it too, but it just was definitely less stress, just, you know, hey, I'm just going to do a show in 6 days.
Right.
You know what I mean? And instead of the hype with, you know, me and Henry, like,
yeah.
I think that's still been a good battle on stage, because, you know, he's about 10 or 15 pounds heavier than me, but sometimes when we stand side by side, it doesn't always show that big weight difference like it did last year in juniors.
I'm pretty sure you guys will meet again in the future.
Oh, I'm sure we will. It'll be fun.
It's good to have that, you know, kind of rivalry. Like, even though we like each other, but sometimes it's good to have some kind of, like, thing like that, a relationship.
Yeah.
Because it just pulls people in. They want to see what's going on. And, you know, bodybuilding can be sort of boring to the fans. So sometimes it's good to have a little something like that going on.
Yep.
So now that you're an IFBB Pro, I mean, I know you haven't talked to Matt much, but, like, in the back of your mind, like, what do you see? Where do you want to be maybe in like a year, maybe five? Like, how do you want to look? You know, what are your goals now that you're an IFBB Pro?
Okay, so my goal is I'd like to take two years solid off, and I need to put that mask on for how tall I am and fill out that frame. And then my goal is to, if I can get an invite to the Arnold in 2019, that would be my goal, since it's in my backyard. You know,
it's
15 minutes from my house. And it would be cool to have, like, all my family and friends there for my pro debut. And Matthew Arnold would be legit.
Yeah, that's a good
point. That's what I want to do.
I like that. So, yeah, I mean, pretty much if anyone wants to maybe get a hold of you, I mean, you have some coaching services, right?
Yes.
How would people get a hold of you, contacts, et cetera?
Yeah, so my Instagram is just STRA_flexin31, and that's on Instagram. And my website is just SethShawFitness.com. And then there's an inquiry page on there if anybody wants any online coaching or whatever.
And then you have a YouTube you started, or is that?
Yeah, well, yeah, I had a YouTube. I opened it up like a couple of years ago. I posted like a few posing routines and stuff. But I'm going to be putting some more content on there. And I think it's just my Instagram name, straightflexin31. Okay. Or you just type in Seth Shaw, it should pop up.
So you just put up a new video, though, sort of.
It goes over basically from Sunday, right after I talked to Matt on the decision, and then it's got like every single day's updates, like throughout the day, and just like, you know, me and John driving there, in the room going to weigh-ins, just kind of like a little week's worth of footage, and it's got the prejudging on there. It's got my routine. It's got like the overall pose down and all that stuff on there, which is pretty cool. It's like a 45-minute video, though, so it's a little long, but it does capture 6 full days of content. So.
Perfect. Well, yeah, make sure to check it out. We'll let you go. Enjoy the rest of your Sunday. This is Nate Spear with Maximum Muscle Report, and this is Seth Shaw. Thank you for joining us again, and we'll see you
later. Thank you.